Let us discuss the situation of interference of sound from two closely spaced sources. When sound waves superpose, two coherent sound waves superpose at a point, then the interference can be easily detected by a sound detector or a mic. Let's discuss two cases of such situation. Case one is one, the detector moves parallel to line joining the sources. Let's first analyze the situation. Say these are two sound sources S1 and S2, which are separated by a closed separation small d. And from the two sources, a large distance away, we place a detector D. Now, if the detector is placed exactly on the perpendicular bisector, we can see when the sources will sound, the waves from sources will cover equal path lengths before reaching the detector. And when the waves will superpose at the location of detector, suddenly a path difference will be zero. Implies constructive interference will take place here, and if the two sources are producing sound of intensity I0 and I0 equal intensity at the location of detector, then the resulting intensity at this position can be written as 4I0. As in previous section we have studied that at the point of constructive interference the resulting intensity becomes 4I0. Now say if the detector starts moving along a line which is parallel to the line joining the sources, then obviously if the detector will move slightly, the path length of source S1 will slightly decrease and that of S2 will increase. So a path difference is created. And if a path difference is created, correspondingly there will be a phase difference. Hence, the intensity will be certainly less than 4I0. Or we can say, as detector will start moving, the intensity will gradually drops. Now, in this situation, at a location of detector, when the path difference is increasing and it becomes equals to lambda by 2, as it is increasing from 0, and if the sound wavelength is lambda, as soon as the path difference becomes lambda by 2, destructive interference takes place and resulting intensity becomes 0. So, here we can see, as we were studying, that as detector started moving, the resulting intensity in the detector is dropping, and this is the location where it will drop down to 0. Again, if we move further, it will start increasing. It will be increasing, and the position where path difference becomes lambda, again the resulting intensity becomes 4I0. And so on, this will be carried over as at every path difference which is multiple of wavelength, constructive interference is there, so intensity will be 4 times the individual intensity, and whenever path difference is an odd multiple of lambda by 2, resulting intensity will drop to 0. Similar maxima and minima will be obtained in the other direction if detector moves here. So, we can see that if detector is constantly moving on this line, it will detect a sound wave in which waxing and waning of sound will take place. It will be increasing, decreasing, increasing, decreasing, and so on. We can also plot the variation curve of intensity with distance. Say if initial location of detector is taken at 0 and this y-axis, so intensity variation can be plotted with y-axis as at y equals to 0, it is 4I0, then it will drop down to 0, then it will increase to 4I0, then drop down to 0 like this. So, you can say this is the way how intensity varies, and if these points are A, B, C, we can say this is 0, this is A, and again at point B it is maximum, then again at C it is becoming 0. Here it is A dash, B dash, C dash. Or maxima, minima, maxima, it will be A dash, B dash and C dash and so on. This is the way how intensity varies. And we can also mathematically find out the locations of these points where maxima and minima of intensity are occurring, for which we need to use the expression for intensity and path difference. Say in general we consider a point which is located at a distance x from point O, which was the initial location of a detector. So this is say a point P, then we can say the path difference of the two waves at point P can be given as S2P minus S1P. So we can simply write path difference at point P will be S2P minus S1P. And as the sources are closely spaced, we can easily find out the difference by dropping a perpendicular from S1 to the line S2P. Say this point is Q. And we can treat these two distances equal, like S1P can be approximately taken as QP. So this S2Q is the extra path which is there in the wave from second source to point P. So this can be approximately written as S2Q. Now if point P is at an angular displacement theta from the initial position, then if this is the normal, this angle can also be written as theta. So this S2Q can be easily written as d sin theta. And for a small theta, if the displacement of detector is not too large, we can write path difference at point P is approximately equal to d theta, as we can write sin theta to be equal to theta. Now here if it is displaced by x, and the separation between detector and line of sources is d, then this can be approximately written as x by d. So with a good level of approximation, the path difference at point P can be written as x by d. Now using this path difference, we can easily find out at which point maxima is occurring and at which point minima is occurring. Like for constructive interference, we know path difference at point P should be n lambda. This implies it gives us dx by capital D is equals to n lambda, which gives us x is equals to n lambda capital D by small d. This can be written as xn. This is the distance of nth position of maxima, or the point where constructive interference is taking place. Similarly, we can write for destructive interference, path difference at point P should be equals to 2n minus 1 lambda, 2n minus 1 lambda by 2, as I'm not taking 2n plus 1 because n equal to 0 doesn't exist. At n equals to 0, it is a maxima. So this should be equal to dx by d, which gives x is equals to 2n minus 1 lambda d by twice of small d. So this xn can be written as distance of nth minima from O. This is the point O is the starting point from where the detector was started. This is the way how we can find out the distance of maxima and minima by using the analysis of constructive and destructive interference and condition of path difference. Similar to the situation we have just now discussed, let's have case 2 of this. This belongs to a situation when detector moves perpendicular to line joining the sources. Say if we consider two sources S1 and S2 which are closely spaced at a separation d, and far away from here at a distance capital D we place a detector at point O. Here we can see the path difference in the two waves arriving at detector at the location O directly can be directly written as small d. because the wave from S2 will directly reach and the path it will cover is S2O. And the other wave from S1 will cover a path S1O. So we can directly write here path difference is D. So if each wave is producing an intensity I0 at the location of detector, we can find out the phase difference as 2 pi by lambda into the path difference, which is D. And if we know the phase difference at the point of interference, we can find out the resulting intensity by using the relation 4 I0 cos square phi by 2, which we have studied in previous sections. You can recall when two equal waves, equal intensity waves of intensity I0 interfere with phase difference phi, the resulting intensity at the point of interference is given by this expression. Now say if the detector will start moving in a line which is perpendicular to the line joining the sources, then we can say the path difference will start decreasing. Initially it was D. Say when this detector will reach infinity at a very far distance, we can say the two waves will almost cover equal path difference. So we can write path difference at infinite position will be 0. And at any general position, which is at a distance x from the initial position at point P, the two waves will travel unequal paths. And the situation here, path difference we can calculate at point P, say it is delta P. Depending on delta P, the intensity will be detected by the detector. So here we can write at position P, path difference can be written as S1P minus S2P, and again as D is very small, for a given angle theta we can drop a perpendicular. This point is Q and this is the extra path which the wave from S1 is covering, which is approximately S1Q. And if this angle is theta, this can also be taken as theta because D is very small. If this D, this can be written as D cos theta. Here theta not necessarily be small because path difference is becoming 0 at very far away from initial position. So x will be significant. So we cannot take theta to be very small like in previous case we have taken. So here path difference will be d cos theta, and we can say if at P there is a maxima which is a point of constructive interference, then we can write this path difference d cos theta will be equals to n lambda. By using this we can find out the value of theta, the angular position of a detector where it will detect a maxima. It can be given as cos inverse of n lambda by d. Similarly, if at P there is a minima, then we can write this path difference d cos theta will be 2n plus 1 lambda by 2, because for destructive interference path difference should be an odd multiple of lambda by 2. So this will give us theta as cos inverse of 2n plus 1 lambda by 2d. Using these expression we can handle various kind of numerical applications. We'll also take up some examples to understand the application of this concept.